Today we will do question number 6 of exercise 13.1. Question number 6 is, a small indoor greenhouse, that is herbarium, is made entirely of glass panes, including base, held together with tape. It is 30 cm long, 25 cm wide and 25 cm high. What is the area of the glass? And second part is, how much of tape is needed for all the 12 edges? Now children, in this question we are given the length of glass, breadth of glass and height of glass, and a herbarium is to be made of a glass only. So herbarium is type of a closed box. So it means, to find the area of glass or area of herbarium, we need to find the total surface area of glass herbarium. That means we have to use the formula 2 into LB plus BH plus HL. As I told you that herbarium is of the shape of closed box, cuboidal box. So total surface area of that herbarium will be 2 into LB plus BH plus HL. So after putting the values of length 30 cm, breadth 25 cm and height 25 cm in this formula, we get 2 into 2125. After adding this, after solving this bracket, we get 2 into 2125. So area of the glass will be 4250 centimeter square. Now in second part, we have to find the length of tape required. Now that glass, all the faces are to be joined with tape, right? So we need the length of tape needed for 12 edges. In 12 edges, in a cuboidal box, in 12 edges, we have 4 lengths, 4 breadths and 4 heights. So length of tape needed for 12 edges means, if we have to, like this is a box, if we have to put the tape here, so one length, second length, third length, fourth length, then breadth 1, 2, similarly 3 and 4, tape is to be put on these breadths also, then on height 1, 2, 3, this third one and this fourth one. So it means length of tape required for 12 edges are 4 into L plus B plus H, 4L plus 4B plus 4H, 4 is common, so it becomes 4 into L plus B plus H. So after putting the values of length, breadth, height, we get the length of tape needed for the 12 edges be 320 cm. So this completes question 6. Now coming to question 7. Shanti Sweets stall was placing an order for making cardboard boxes for packing their sweets, right? Now two types of boxes were required. The bigger box are of dimension 25 by 20 by 5 and smaller box dimensions are 15, 12 and 5 cm. For all the overlaps, 5% of the total surface area is required extra. So if the cost of cardboard is rupees 4 for 1000 cm square, find the cost of cardboard required for supplying 250 boxes of each kind. Now in this question, we are given two types of boxes. Like you see the sweets in different types of boxes, bigger boxes, smaller boxes. So same way, Shanti Sweets stall has to put sweets in those boxes, and they need the boxes. And there are two types of boxes. One is bigger box and other is smaller box. And naturally, in making the boxes, overlapping is also required. Cardboard is to be overlapped also, so 5% extra is required for overlapping. So we have to find what will be the cost of cardboard required for making 250 such boxes of bigger as well as smaller type. Now you can see length of bigger box is given, breadth and height is given. So imagine that sweet boxes are like a closed box. So it means we need the total surface area of both the boxes. First we will find total surface area of bigger box. So total surface area of bigger box is 2 into LB plus BH plus HL. So after putting the values of LB, then BH and then HL and multiplying, and we get the total surface area of bigger box as 1450 centimeter square. Now this is the total surface area of one box. We need total surface area of 250 bigger boxes. So 1450 into 250, that means 36250 centimeter square is the total surface area of 250 bigger boxes. Now we need to find total surface area of smaller box also. So length, breadth and height of smaller boxes is also given, and again the smaller boxes are also like a closed cuboid box. So we need the total surface area of smaller box also, that is 2 into LB plus VH plus HL, and after putting the values of LBH we get 2 into 315, that is 630 centimeter square is the total surface area of smaller boxes, one smaller box. Now we find total surface area of 250 smaller boxes, that will be 630 into 250, 157500 centimeter square. Now we will add both the areas of both type of boxes. So total surface area of 250 boxes of both type, both type means smaller as well as bigger box total surface area. So after adding both the areas of smaller as well as bigger box, we get the total surface area of both type will be 520000 centimeter square. Now area required for overlapping, what is the extra area we need? The extra area also that is required for overlapping, 5% of the total surface area, and total surface area is this one. So 5 upon 100 into 520000. So after cutting 00 cancels, we get overlapping area required is 26,000 centimeter square. So total surface area of both boxes, both type of boxes with overlapping. With overlapping means this is the total surface area of both boxes plus this is extra for overlapping. For overlapping, 26,000 centimeter square of area is required. So after adding both the areas, we get the total surface area with overlapping of both type of boxes as 546,000 centimeter square. Now we have to find the cost. We got the area of both type of boxes. Now we need the cost of cardboard required for, now it is given for 1000 centimeter square, the cost is 4 rupees. So using unitary method, we'll find the cost of cardboard for 1 centimeter square, that is 4 by 1000, and cost of cardboard required for the given area, whatever we have find the area of both type of boxes with overlapping, that is 546,000 centimeter square is equal to rate multiplied by area. Rate is 4 by 1000 into 546,000. So zeros cancels, we get 2184 is the cost of cardboard required for supplying 250 boxes of each kind. So this is how we can do question number 7. Now coming to question number 8, Parveen wanted to make a temporary shelter for her car by making a box-like structure with tarpaulin. Tarpaulin is a sort of fabric which is waterproof, right? Tarpaulin that covers all the four sides and the top of the car with the front face as a flap which can be rolled up. Assuming that the stitching margins are very small and therefore negligible. Negligible means none, equal to nil. How much tarpaulin would be required to make the shelter of height 2.5 meter with base dimension 4 meter and 3 meter? Now we need that, we have to find what area of tarpaulin cloth is required that will cover the four sides and the top of car. It means we have to find area of four walls plus area of the top of car. So we are given the length. Length of shelter is given 4 meter, breadth of shelter is given 3 meter. Shelter means where we can where we keep our car safely to protect them from sunlight or rain. So that is shelter. So length of shelter is, and that in that shelter the car is to be covered with the tarpaulin cloth which protect the car from sunlight or rain. So length of shelter is 4 meter, breadth 3 meter, height is 2.5 meter. So area of tarpaulin required is area of four walls plus area of top of the car is to be. So in this, area of four walls is 2 into L plus B into H, and area of top is L into B. So putting the values of L, B, H, we get the area of tarpaulin required is 47 centimeter square. So I hope this exercise 13.1 is clear to all of you. Now coming to the next topic, we have learned about cuboids and cube till now. Now we are going to, I'm going to tell you about cylinder. Now children, what is a cylinder? Yes, what is a cylinder? If we take a number of circular sheets of paper, right? If we take so many sheets, circular sheets of paper, and we keep one upon another, right? And we stack them as we have stacked up rectangular sheets in the case of cuboid. If we want to get a cuboidal box, what we do? If we keep the rectangular sheet one upon another, so we get a big stack of rectangular sheet which actually look like a box, like structure. Similarly, when we keep circular paper one upon another, so we get a this sort of picture, right? If we keep circular papers one upon another, so we get a cylinder like structure. So if the stack is kept vertically up, we get what it is called. It is a right circular cylinder. Why it is right circular cylinder? Because the distance between both the bases is at 90 degree, right? So that is why they are called right circular cylinder. And in class 9th we will deal only right circular cylinders. We have few cylinders are of this shape also, tilted cylinders, but we will not deal with such type of cylinders in this class. So we are going to deal with this type of cylinder. So this is cylinder. So when we place one circular paper upon another, after keeping so many circular papers one upon another, so we get a cylinder like structure. Your pen, pencil or pipe, all are examples of cylinder, right? And you can see the top, this is a cylinder. This is the top of cylinder and this is the bottom of cylinder. Top and bottom faces of cylinder are called bases. So these are called the bases of cylinder. And if the radius of base, bottom face is R, it means the radius of upper face will also be R. And perpendicular distance between both the bases is called the height of cylinder. Is that clear? That will become the height of cylinder. Now, what is the curved surface area of cylinder? Now, to find the curved surface area of cylinder, what you have to do, take a rectangular sheet with length as L and breadth as H. We'll not take breadth as B, we'll take breadth as H. Why? I will tell you. When we take a rectangular sheet like this, I have taken a rectangular sheet. When I will fold it, you can see, when I will fold it, it will look like a cylinder. It will look like a cylinder. So it will look like a cylinder. So when I fold this rectangular sheet, you can see length of rectangle will become the circumference of circle. The top face is circular in shape, and the length will become the circumference of circle, and the height, this breadth, which was H. So this height becomes, this breadth becomes the height of cylinder, right? So when this rectangular shield is folded to form a cylinder, so this H will become the height of cylinder and this L will become the circumference of this cylinder. This, when we fold it along its length, we get the length will become the circumference of cylinder. So what will be the area of this rectangle? What will be the area of rectangle? Length into breadth. Now, curved surface area of cylinder is actually equal to area of rectangular sheet, because this sheet is converted into this cylinder. So curved surface area of this cylinder will be equal to area of this rectangular sheet, and area of rectangle is L into B, length into breadth. And as I told you, length will become the circumference of the cylinder. This base, this is circular in shape, so this length will become the circumference of the base of cylinder, and this breadth of rectangle will become the height of cylinder. So length into breadth, length will be replaced by circumference of the base of cylinder, and breadth is height. And circumference of base of cylinder, as you can see, the upper base is circular in shape and circumference of circle is 2 pi r. So it becomes 2 pi r h. So curved surface area of cylinder is 2 pi rh. This is how we have derived this formula to find the curved surface of area of cylinder. Now to find the total surface area of cylinder, what you have to do, curved means this portion, and for total surface area we have to add the upper area of upper base as well as area of bottom base, which are circular in shape. So area of top face plus curved surface area of cylinder plus area of bottom face makes the total surface area of cylinder. So area of top face, as you can see, the top face is circular in shape. So area of circle is pi r square. CSA of cylinder, curved surface area of cylinder, we have already find 2 pi rh, plus area of bottom face is also circular in shape, so area will be pi r square. Pi r square plus pi r square makes it 2 pi r square plus 2 pi rh. Then you can see 2 pi r is common. We get 2 pi r r plus h as the total surface area of cylinder. And you just, when we find total surface area of cylinder, it means the cylinder is a closed cylinder, right? When it is open from top, then we have to take curved surface area of cylinder and area of bottom only, right? If the cylinder is open from top, then we have to find the area of curved portion as well as the area of bottom only. In case of closed cylinder, if it is closed from the top as well as from the bottom, then we use this formula 2 pi r r plus h. And if we want to find only the curved portion, then we need this formula. And to find the volume of cylinder, I already told you that in case to find volume of any 3D figure, the formula is the area of base into height. So as you can see, the area of base is circular in shape and its area is pi r square, and height is h here. So pi r square h is the volume of cylinder. So this is how curved surface area of cylinder, total surface area of cylinder and volume of cylinder is derived. Now coming to exercise 13.2, which is based on cylinder only. Question number 1 is, the curved surface area of right circular cylinder of height 14 cm is 88 cm square. Find the diameter of the base of cylinder. Now in this question, children, height is given and curved surface area of cylinder is given. So we have to find diameter. But before diameter, I told you, I'll just tell you, before diameter, we'll find radius. And diameter is double of radius. So once we have find radius, we can easily find out diameter. So height of cylinder 14 cm, curved surface area of cylinder is 88 cm square. And what is the formula of CSA of cylinder? 2 pi rh, which is equal to 88. So 2 into pi, value of pi is 22/7. So assume always pi 22/7 unless stated otherwise. It means if in question it is not mentioned that take pi 3.14, if it is not mentioned, then take pi is equal to 3.14. So you will take pi 22/7 only, right? So value of pi is 22/7, r is not given, h is 14. 7 and 14 is cancelled. So 22 2s are 44, 44 2s are 88, r is equal to 88. So r will be 88/88, that is 1. So radius is 1 and diameter is double of radius. So diameter will be 2 cm. So very simple. Question number 1. Coming to question 2. It is required to make a closed cylindrical tank of height 1 meter and base diameter 140 cm from a metal sheet. Now we need to make a closed cylindrical tank. It means we need total surface area of cylindrical tank. And it is to be made of a metal sheet. How many square of metal sheet is required for the same? So again, height of tank is 1 meter and base diameter is 140. Diameter is given, so radius is half of diameter, that is 70 centimeter. And now you can see height is in meter and radius is in centimeter. And we need how many square meter of metal sheet is required. It means we need the area of sheet in meter square. So convert centimeter into meter. And I told you to convert centimeter into meter divided by 100. So 70/100 meter, that is 0.7. 0 cancels with 0. So we get the radius of cylinder as 0.7 meter. Then area of sheet required for making a closed cylindrical tank is actually equal to the total surface area of tank, which is 2 pi r r plus h. So putting the value of pi 22/7, r 0.7, again r 0.7 and h 1, 0.7, 0.7, after removing point, we get 10 in the denominator, 7 and 7 cancel. So 44 by 10 into 1.7. So it becomes 4.4 into 1.7. That makes 7.48 meter square. So this is the area of metal sheet required, is equal to 7.48 meter square. So this completes question number 2 of exercise 13.2. So in the next module, we'll be doing other questions of exercise 13.2. Thank you so much.